Congratulations on the purchase of your new Scorpion Truck Mounted Attenuator by TrafFix Devices, the leader in highway safety products. This video will demonstrate the proper assembly of the Scorpion Truck Mounted Attenuator. Caution must be used when unloading and handling this unit prior to assembly. Remember to always use personal protection equipment. Failure to exercise the outlined safety precautions and assembly procedures could invalidate your warranty and cause physical harm to your personnel. The strut and cartridge of the Scorpion truck-mounted attenuator are shipped vertically. Carefully loosen the tie straps on both the strut and the cartridge. Do not allow others to stand within the assembly area. The unit could fall over if pushed by a force. Use extreme caution while working with the unit in a vertical position. Unload with a forklift. Use pallet extensions that travel at least 3/4 of the width of the pallet. Keep personnel clear at all times. Remove both the Scorpion truck-mounted attenuator cartridge and strut from the truck. The strut has one yellow module and the cartridge has two yellow modules and one black module. Inspect the shipment for any damage. The Scorpion truck-mounted attenuator serial number should match the bill of lading. Have the driver sign the bill of lading. Observe the warning signs taped under the Scorpion cartridge. You must follow these procedures to avoid falling parts when unpacking. Metal banding straps secure the Scorpion truck-mounted attenuator to the pallet. Remove the plastic wrap around the unit with a utility knife. Be careful not to cut any wires or Scorpion parts. After the plastic wrap is removed, confirm the serial numbers on the bill of lading. Remove the banding straps from the pallet. Remove all cardboard and check for damage. Strut assembly. Attach lifting straps with a 1,500-pound or greater load capacity to the strut diaphragm, an equal distance from the center. Do not tip the strut while attaching the lifting straps. Position the forklift with the swivel jacks toward the forklift. Place the strut on the edge of the pallet while supporting the strut with the forklift. Back away, very slowly, until the drop jacks can be lowered within reach of the installer. Do not let the lift straps slide completely off with the forklift blades. Extend the drop jack leg until the yellow mark at the top is aligned with the bottom of the drop jack mounting bracket. The yellow paint should not be visible when set to the correct height. Insert the safety snap. Support the strut with the forklift until the drop jacks touch the floor. Remove the lifting straps and reattach to the backup of the Scorpion. Raise the strut until it is level. Lower the swivel jacks so that the strut is level. Cut the zip tie holding the hydraulic cylinder. Remove the hairpin and clevis pin, set aside for future use. Cartridge assembly. Now you are ready to unpack the cartridge. Keep the cartridge frame attached to the pallet while removing the parts. Remove the metal banding straps on the cartridge that hold the components to the cartridge. Use caution when unpacking. Parts may have moved during shipment and may fall when unpacking. Remove all cardboard. Unbolt the junction box from the cartridge. Then remove the module C. Cut the straps that hold the cartridge frame to the pallet. Open the parts box and confirm the contents. Remove the two clevis pins with the cotter pin. Move the cartridge frame by placing the forklift blades under module B. Use cardboard to protect the paint surface of the module B. Lift and align the hinges on the cartridge and strut with a forklift. It is essential that this be done on a level surface so that the pins will align properly. Warning: The hinges on the backup have a pinch point when the cartridge is raised into the vertical position. Watch your hands to avoid getting pinched during alignment. Avoid placing your hands, fingers, or arms between the strut and cartridge while moving either unit. Push the cartridge into the final alignment position. Set the forklift to the park position so that it does not move. Tap the hinge pin and washer into position. Secure with the cotter pin. Bolt the lockout arm to the cartridge frame diaphragm. Attach the two bolts and use red thread locker on the bolt threads. Make sure the bolt heads are placed on the cartridge side. Tighten the bolts to 95 foot-pounds of torque on the lockout arm. Block all four wheels, front and back, then lower the cartridge frame. Secure the hydraulic cylinders to the cartridge frame with the clevis pin and hairpin. Lift the Module C energy absorber into position. Apply thread locking adhesive on the 1/4 inch by 1 1/4 inch bolts. Use a washer and tighten to a minimum of 20 foot-pounds, securing the Module C to the diaphragm. Secure the electrical junction box to Module C. Attach the cable clamps with a bolt. Plug in the power cable to the junction box from the strut to the Module C. Use a zip tie to secure the electrical safety harness. Attach energy absorber Module A to the cartridge frame. Use red thread locking adhesive with all bolts. Cut this zip tie and connect the electrical cable to the cable located in the back of energy Module A. Use a zip tie to secure the cable. The assembly of the Scorpion mounted attenuator is now complete. Remember, 1. Assembly must be done on a flat level surface that is large enough to use a forklift. 2. Extra caution must be taken when working with the strut or cartridge in a vertical position. It could fall if knocked over by a force. 3. Use a forklift with lift cables to support assembly whenever possible. 4. Watch for pinch points. Do not put your hands, fingers, arm, or body in the way when attaching the strut or cartridge components. 5. Inspect the parts list prior to assembly. Make sure all of the required assembly parts are here before you begin. Thank you for watching this video. Contact TrafFix Devices or your certified attenuator program dealer should you need any help with the assembly or replacement parts.